Hello dear friends, in this session we are going to understand how to connect to Oracle database from Java program. First we will discuss about how to create the Oracle database, then how to connect to that database, how to create table in the Oracle using SQL++, and then we will also understand how to insert some record into the table, how to create a table. Then we will understand how to connect to that particular table or database from a Java program. So let's start understanding how to create the Oracle database. So first, you have to create the Oracle database, or the default Oracle database which is created is ORCL. If you want to create your own database, you can search for the Oracle in start menu. Inside the start menu there is the Oracle option. Here on this machine, Oracle 10g database is installed. So inside this Oracle 10g there is a database configuration assistant option. Once you click on this, you will get a separate wizard for creating database in Oracle. So this is the wizard where you can create the Oracle database. So you have to click on this next option, then you have to choose this create database option, then click on next. Then you can choose the purpose of your database. If you want to create a database for general purpose or specify some custom option, you can choose the option whichever you want to use. Then you can click on the next. Then you have to specify the database name here. So here I am going to specify the database name as StudentDB. Then you have to click on next. In this step, you can click on next. Here you have to add the Oracle database user. So here I am going to add the password for database user. I am specifying the password as Coxy to all the users, that is SY, system, DBNMS and sysman. To all these users I am using the same password. If I want to specify the different user, different password for different user, I can choose this particular option. Okay, if I choose this particular option, it means I am going to use the same password for all these users in Oracle. Now, you have to select the listener for your database. Register this database with listener. If you want to choose this particular listener, you can choose, or a new listener will be created for this database so that you will be able to connect this listener, means to this listener to the Oracle database. Okay, so new listener will be created for this. If you want to use the existing listener for this database, you can choose this particular option. Then you have to click on next. Again you have to click on the next, and you have to click on the finish. Okay, finish. Once that, a wizard will create a database. So it takes some time to create a database. After completion of all these steps, your database will be ready. After completion of this process, your database is created. You can now click on this exit option, and then you can start the SQL+. And now you can log in using the system and the password that we have given is Coxy. So now your SQL+ is ready. Now you can create a table in that. Create table student, in which I am going to create roll number as integer and name as var character 30. Now the table is created. I am going to add some record into this to add the values. The values keyword is needed. Here I am adding the first record as 10 and Ram. Again, I am going to add the next record as Dash. Now, I am going to select the record from this student table. So, these are the records. So, these records I want to display from my Java program. So, now we can move towards the Java program. We'll understand the procedure for connecting the Oracle database from Java program, and we'll connect to that and we'll get the record from this database. Here I'm going to create a new project in Eclipse. Oracle connection demo is the name of the Oracle data connection is the name of project that I am specifying here, and after that I am going to click on finish. So for module file I am not going to create the module file here. So after that a project is added in Eclipse. So you have to right click on your project, then choose new, then choose class file, then you have to specify the student data name of your class file, and I am going to add the main function in that. After I click on this finish button, one class will be added here. So here you can write the code. Now first you have to add the libraries that is needed for connecting to Oracle database. So for that you first right click on your project, then choose the build path, then configure build path, then choose the libraries, then class path, add external jar file. Here the jar file for connecting to Oracle database is already installed on this machine, already downloaded from internet on this machine. So name of the file is OJDBC14. You can download this file from internet by searching OJDBC14. So you have to select this file that is required for Oracle connection. So here I am selecting this particular file, and after that I am going to click on this apply and close option. Now you can write some code or the steps to connect to the Oracle database. First you have to import the package for connecting to database, that is java.sql. After that you can create the connection class in that package, the object of connection class, then object of statement class. This connection object is used to establish connection to database, and this statement class is used to execute a SQL command on database. Now you have to load the driver first for connecting to Oracle, and while loading the driver there may error occur. To handle that error we need to write a try catch block. So here I am handling this particular exception if the error is occurred while connecting to database. t.getMessage is a function that is used for displaying the proper messages about the error. Now to load the driver, you have to call the for name function of class. Then to this function, we need to pass the name of the driver. So name of the driver for connecting to Oracle database is oracle.jdbc.driver.oracle.driver. You have to put the name of the driver here. Then you have to initialize the connection by calling the get connection function of driver manager. And to this driver get connection function of driver manager, you have to pass the URL of Oracle database, and along with that you have to also specify the username and password. So the URL for connecting to Oracle database is jdbc:oracle:thin@localhost, then port number and the name of your database. So here I am going to specify this. So I am going to connect to the student database. Student DB is the database that we have created just now. To access this database, we need to specify a username. The default username is, I am using here is system, and the password that I am using here is coxit. This password I have specified at the time of creation of database. While creating this student DB database, I have specified this coxit password here. Now, so this statement will initialize the connection, will connect to the Oracle database. Now we can fire some commands on database. So for that you have to create a statement, and you have to initialize the statement object. So this create statement function returns the statement object, and the statement object will initialize. Now using this statement object, you can fire some command on database. To execute or to fire the select command on Oracle database or any database, we have to use this execute query function. And the table that we have created is student. From this student table, we want to display the record. So whatever the records are there in the student table, so this particular query function returns the object of result set. So I have created the object arrays here, and I can move towards the result set last record. So for that I am writing here loop, and in which I am calling the next function of result set object. So this function will check whether there is a next record in the table or the result set. If there is a next record, the condition will be true and we'll be able to access that particular record. So for accessing the record from that result set or from the student class, you have to call the get function. For getting the integer column value, you have to call the get integer function, and then you have to specify the name to the column. Then rs.getString is the function for getting the value of text column in the database. So here I am specifying the name of the second column as name. So this, in between that I want to concatenate the slash t. So for that I have written here slash t. Now this particular program will be able to display the record in the student table. Now we can check for the output whether this program works as per the requirement or not. Okay, so here the program doesn't display any error. So one thing you need to specify here, once we insert the record into the student table, we need to fire the commit statement. Once that, all the changes will be performed in the database successfully. Now again I am going to run this program. Now at that time this program shows the record in the student database. So in this way we can connect to the Oracle database and we can get the record from that particular table from Oracle. I hope you understand. Thank you.